Morning and welcome to day two of Cheltenham Chat, the time form. Today I'm joined by Kieran Clark and Chris Hilliam.
Yep, that was second and final appearance of the week for me.
Okay, so yesterday was a terrible day for me. I had a shocker. I was 0-6, so I need a winner today. So we're going to start with your bankers. Kieran, who was your banker of the day?
Yeah, so for me it's Envoy Allen in the first. I've tried my hardest to probably get him beat, but I can't see how he does get beat, really. You look at his form when he won that Royal Bond. He beat Abracadabra's runner-up in the Supreme yesterday. Darvis Star was third, who then went to finish second in the Irish Champion Hurdle and third in our equivalent yesterday as well. Then he won the Lowlands of Nace. He easily beat Elixir Adane, who was still going well when he fell in the Supreme yesterday. Yeah. Well, you say fell, Austerian for Lange kind of took him out of the race.
I was on Elixir,
Time form rate is 154 with a large P. I just think he's the best horse in the race, really. Sporting John probably his nearest pursuer. We've got him at 150 with a small P. He's a good horse, Sporting John. I just don't know if he's got the class of Envoy Allen. He idles in front, but he does battle as well. He showed that when he won the bumper last year.
Yeah.
Just looking at what's against him today, as well as Sporting John, you've got the two bigs, the big breakaway, the big getaway. Both look embryonic chasers to me. I just think Envoy Allen's more the finished article right now. I think they're two nice horses for next season, but I just really can't see how he gets beat. 4-6. I haven't backed him at that price, but if you're looking to put a short one in, he'd be the one for me, really.
Yeah, so he's about 5-4 at the start of the festival, wasn't he?
Well,
on now.
Yeah, Gordon Elliott came out and said that he might run him in the Supreme when it was really wet, but that's why he drifted a little bit. But I just think he's best horse in the race, and he is a chaser in the making probably as well, but I honestly don't see how he gets beat, really.
No, can't really disagree.
Yeah, I've just played a big price, easy work in that race. I think he's probably got better form than the others. Might run into a place at big price, but I wouldn't be willing to take Envoy. I think Envoy will win the race.
I would give a quick mention to Longhouse Poet as well. It's owned by the same connections who won the race last year. The owner actually sponsors the race.
Yeah.
So I just thought that was interesting, maybe trying to win it again. But he was third to Envoy Allen last time. You know, I can't see how he turns the tables.
He'll be fully tuned up, won't he?
That's
a different question,
Maybe in each way a bit. Yeah, so, Chris, what about your banker?
Chuck and Paul Swarzman, which has been one of my bankers for the festival even before. So
yeah, I like him as well.
That's discouraging news of Altior. I think it's always deserved to be a short price at Defi Desai. So we've seen a lot of arguments at Defi Desai. It's got the Cheltenham form and Chuck and Paul Swarzman hasn't, but you take the time they met, literally, and it was a bit of a hammering, really. It was 4.5 lengths, going on 6 or 7 lengths. It was quite straightforward. I just think it's a better horse. It's top rating with ourselves on the adjusted ratings, and still got much potential to improve even further. Even with Alto in the race, it'd be a bit better. It was about 11-4. What is it now? So half that.
Yeah, 11-8.
Yeah, 11-8. Best price. Yeah.
Still with it. Still think it's a better horse than Definitely Sorry. He'd be close between them. It should be a good race, but definitely
savage. Yeah, no, I'm with you. Yeah, with the Cheltenham form thing, I think, like we discussed yesterday, until it's actually flopped, then there's no reason to think that he won't handle it at Cheltenham. So, so we've got Envoy Allen and Chacon. So, let's move on to the lays. Chris, you want to start with the lays?
Yeah, we're a bit more successful in this department yesterday, apparently. I've not got anything I want to take on as such in terms of the short prices there. Don't want to be against Envoy Allen, as we just said.
Yeah.
Don't really want to be against Tiger Roll, even though Easy Land's got every chance. I think Kieran's got one in one of the other races. So what I've come up with is a place late on the favourite in the Coral Cup, Dandy Compania. Reason I say a place, seems a bit fragile with the time she's had in between her races to now. I think if she doesn't look like she's going to win, I think she'll be looked after by Barry Geraghty, which means if she doesn't win, she probably won't place. So I just think it's not that big a price to play, so we're not losing an awful lot if it does win compared to if it was a win only lace or place lay for that for me. Thinking it'll be first or somewhere down the field.
Yeah, okay, so you can lay her about.
I think with that, I think they might have just laid her out for the race after she won last time. Because Indefatigable came out and won at Warwick. The handicap and they actually raised Dandy Compania £2, which was then appealed and then successfully appealed to remains on the £8 rise rather than £2 higher. So it'd be interesting if that £2 does play into account.
Yeah,
if she wins by a neck, for example.
That'd be a talking point, at least. Yeah, like I wouldn't be all the surprised if she did win, because she's probably a worthy favourite, so, but it's more just at the price of it. What is the place low price? It's at 2.4.
Yeah.
So we're not losing an awful lot if she does win and we get as many, because I think Barry won't be bothered playing for third, fourth place if she's not going to win.
Yeah,
yeah. Fair enough. Yeah, okay. Yeah, Kieran,
your lay? Yeah, my lay of the day would be appreciate it in the bumper. Same connections who Chris successfully got carefully selected beat in the last yesterday. He just looks like a 3 mile chaser on looks and the way he runs. And he won a bumper over 2.5 the first time, then they dropped him back to 2 mile at Leopardstown last time. They didn't really go pace. His main market rival Eric Bloodock's disappointed. They didn't really go pace, but he doesn't quicken. He just sort of lengthens like a galloper. And I just worry, has he got the pace to lay up at a really fast run 2 mile? I can see him getting outpaced down the hill and then running on again late. If he does win this and if he does travel through the race, I think he's an absolute monster. You know, I'd be very surprised if he does, but if he doesn't, he's definitely awesome.
Yeah, similar situation to Carefully Selected yesterday, isn't it? In that good horse, but still a very short price for this race.
Yeah, 7-4 in a big field bumper, it's not for me.
It seems to be following the same pattern as Carefully Selected in the price as well, don't it? Where it seemed short anyway and then got shorter on the day of racing as well.
William Mullins won 9 bumpers before as well. So.
Yeah, he went off odds on.
Traded odds on him running as well, which I couldn't lay up. Completely agree on that. Just
on ratings as well. Really. If you look at the ratings, we've got
Panic Attack.
Appreciate it on 119. Panic Attack's 110, but being a 4-year-old filly, she gets £13 allowance. Mm. Queensbrook, we've got a 111 with a £7 allowance. So even the rating suggests there's not much between them.
Yeah.
And the market seems to suggest there is. And I think it's just the Mullins factor. He's won 9 bumpers at Cheltenham before, and that's probably why he's short.
Yeah.
So that'll be my lay of the day now.
Yeah, okay, fair enough. All right, so let's move on to an outsider of the day. Chris, do you want to take this first?
Yeah, I'm going to be greedy and go with 2 again, sort of 1. That's overpriced, but probably won't place, but it's a massive price if it does, and doesn't deserve to be as big as it is. In Sayo, in the Cold Cup,
okay.
I think it's the outside of the pack, and it's third top on the Time Form Adjusted Ratings, suggesting that it's better handicapped than quite a lot of these ones coming over from Ireland. The BHA seems to have absolutely hammered, as they do every year. Most of them tend to improve for it anyway, don't they? And sort of negate the rise, but say excuses last time. It started the season over fences, didn't really jump, and they went back over hurdles and struggled jumping as well. Seems to have lost confidence. But last time in a competitive handicap, jumped a lot better. The trip was too long for me there. I think he'd be much better suited by today's trip. But as we say, it's we look at 66-180.
Yeah, you've got 80s.
And I certainly don't think if it completes, it'll be. I think it'll be more in the top half of the field than the bottom half.
Yeah. Okay.
Like Sabes, unlikely to go close, but it's definitely an overpriced.
Yeah.
And then I've got sort of a more set one in there that's got a chance of winning, which was going to be Blacko in the Fred Winter when I looked last night, seeing that it's been backed in from about 16-1 last night and is now favourite. So I had a quick rethink on that, and just going with wanting to take on Appreciate It in the bumper, as Kieran's mentioned, just like the look of third time lucky at a good each way price in that. It was very impressive last time, just done absolutely nothing wrong. They had one that was very well back to the bumper scale last year, didn't they?
Yeah.
That disappointed, but hopefully we can right that wrong. I think that's probably a big price, and if
we are looking 18s.
To get Appreciated, there's nothing going to be travelling stronger than third time rookie, I would have thought.
Yeah, and I think if third time rookie was trained by the likes of an Elliott or a Mullins, he'd be half the price, so I think it's probably...
Yeah, it's a good point.
Yeah, horsing focus as well, so yeah, I could get behind that. Okay. Keep
yeah, in. For me, two outsiders for me. I'll start with Coral Cup, horse called Top Moon of Joseph O'Brien's. I think you can forgive the run last time. He was unsuited by the dropping trip back down to 2 miles. Time before, he chased home Alpha Mix, who reopposes again today over 2.5. But he came from further back that day, maybe not ideally placed. And I just thought 25-1 was a big price. There has been a bit of money this morning. It's sort of 18, 16s in places now. Still thought that was a decent each way bet, especially with some firms playing first six.
Yeah,
I think Paddy Power are playing first seven.
That's
all right. So I thought that was a bit of value. And then Time White in the Boodles, what used to be the Fred Winter. Paul Nichols won this 3 times the last 10 years. Interesting, I read his column on Betfair, which is definitely worth a read. And he said after he got beat at Sandown the first time by Goshen, he got beat sort of 34 lengths. But he actually said when Harry Compton jumped off that day, he said, "Oh, don't worry, we'll win the Boodles." And okay. sort of here we are, yeah. two wins later. I liked his win at Musselburgh. Rated 124p, plenty of improvement to come. I just think he might be trained for the race, really. And well documented yesterday, Nichols didn't have a runner, so he's in the pub. Well, hopefully he can take Andy Stewart back to the pub and celebrate after this win. So it's about 12-14-1.
Is that the price point being pushed out any by all the money coming in for Blackhawk this morning at all?
No, it's been pretty solid, really, around the same price. It hasn't sort of drifted out, but yeah, it just seems to be the gamble on that favourite. But if it does push it out a couple of points,
that's good news.
Happy days.
Yeah, okay.
Got a couple of both handicaps
those days. Yeah, plenty to go out,
On the grading races
Good. Right, so that's the betting done. We're going to move on to the champion chase. Obviously, Altiora's absence, big talking point, bit of a disappointment because it looked like a race for the ages. But it's still a good match. You've already touched on Chacon.
Yeah.
What do you think about the race?
It's still got potential to be a great race, hasn't it? Still two top-class, two-mile chasers in there. And then it's not a terrible supporting cast by any means.
Mm.
Dynamite Dollars probably improved from that run last time. It won't be an awful lot by Altiora as well, will it? It is a shame. So I thought it was going to be the race of the week with Altiora in there.
Yeah.
Obviously, everyone had opinions. You're probably looking at 33% split between the top three, weren't you? Which was sort of why I led to Chacon being the bigger price of the three.
Yeah.
But still a race I'm very much looking forward to.
Yeah.
I hope it's close. Like one Chacon to win, but I hope it's spectacle. Similar to what we got yesterday in a few of the races, notably where it was billed as a match with Benedict Joe Honeysuckle, if we can
get something
akin to that,
it'd
be a good race.
Yeah,
it's pretty much echoing what you've said with Shaston Riley. I think he should be favourite. We've got a nice rated chaser in training, 176p. He ran to a massive time figure when he, at the same time figure as his rating, when he beat Min at Leopardstown. I've not seen a horse glide past Min like that. That jumped free out, he just glided past him effortlessly. He hammered Deffy Desai in Punchestown last year. There is the argument that Deffy had only, he'd had a hard season, Shaston had only had one run, but I thought the best horse won on the day. And for me, similar to Chris, I fancied him even with Altiora in the race.
I think he's the best horse,
So I think he'll win. You got Sir Ryland for Litterlog in there that chased on Altiora last year. Whether that'll be good enough to win this version, probably not. I just don't understand why he's not favourite, really.
Yeah.
I think it might be the sort of English-Irish angle. A lot of people over here seem to fancy Deffy. He was impressive at Ascot, but I don't think
he's a popular horse, isn't he?
He beat Underso, he probably wasn't at his best.
He's been a popular horse ever since his juvenile days.
Okay, so let's move on to the RSA. This is a competitive race, isn't it?
Race of the day, really.
Stole the mantle from...
Yeah, it really has, struggling,
absence,
to, struggling to split the top three, four in the market, really. So, Kieran, what do you think about the RSA?
I've got quite a strong view on this, actually. I really fancy Champ. I'd probably say it's similar to when Mike Bike came into this race off the back of a fall, and he sort of split opinions. You know, do you want to be with him or against him? Watching that dipper back last time, when Geraghty made his mind up for him, he really did jump well, and then he's kind of gone there asking him to pop two out, and he's just hit it with his shoulder. You know, he didn't even take off, really, but I just think if he makes his mind up today and he jumps well, I think he'll win. I think he's the classiest horse in the race. A few people have said, you know, so I think he'll stay. It was 3 mile at Aintree last year. I know this is a different test, but the dam's a half sister to Best Mate and Cornish Rebel. All they did was stay all day. For me, we've got him as top rated. He's probably my strongest fancy in the race, really. You know, McCoy's come out and said we ran him in the wrong race at Cheltenham last year, we should have run him in the Albert Bartlett, so they obviously think he's a strong stayer. He'd be the strongest one at the top of the market for me anyway. Aloha, I think he will stay. I'm surprised Easy Games running here. I thought he'd run in the Marsh. The vibes are that he's improved, but whether he'll stay or truly run 3 mile, I'm not entirely sure.
Easy Game was high up on my shortlist.
I'm surprised
he ran that. But mentioned about Aloha staying, do you think it's fair enough to say that the Albert Bartlett, as a novice third, was probably as much, if not more, of a standard test?
Yeah, it tends to be.
As a novice chaser, it wasn't as strong stayer as Manila Endo in that race last year, but I think it'd be harsh to say he didn't stay that trip. I think Aloha will stay the trip. It's not a race I'd be like wanting to have a bet in. I really like the look of the race. We touched on yesterday. Both myself and Jake and have backed Copperhead in the three and three quarter miler yesterday.
Yeah.
But we still give it every chance in this. I would have Champ favourite. I think Champ ought to be favourite on what they've shown on the fences. Minella Endo's there and what he's shown on hurdles and what he did at Cheltenham last year, really.
Yeah,
but
okay.
Terrific race. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, it should be a good race. Yeah.
Just to touch on Copperhead, I find it interesting that Robbie Powers riding Slate House over Copperhead. Whether Tizard's persuaded him or whether that's his personal preference, I'm not entirely sure. But I know they were really confident in the Cotswold Chase. He'd run a good race and he bombed off for whatever reason. I'm not sure if he was, if they found anything after that. But
obviously,
yeah, interesting that Robbie
Powell doesn't come ahead and go for this far enough in advance that he's had plenty of time to make the decision as well.
Yeah.
I think it's a race chock full of
improvement. We've just got any views on Battle of Diane, obviously, who was sort of one of the Irish bankers for the festival last year, weren't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, I backed him for the race at Ballymore last year and he bombed out and I thought he's a novice chaser to follow next season and he didn't really impress me massively.
Yeah.
And then it's like the two biggest tests of his life. He fell last time when he was held by Fahine. I know it was a dropping trip, which probably didn't suit, but I thought he'd run better than what he did and then he bombed out in this last year. I'm just wondering, have they run him in the right race? Would he be better off in the four-mile yesterday?
Possibly. I don't think it'd really surprise me if he went closer.
No, that's
true. Sorry, it's throughout the first half of last season, do we? But certainly what we've seen of offences, none deserve to be close to the top five in the market.
Yeah, just touching on Manella Rindo as well, I think, again, when they won the Albert Bartlett last year, they beat a lot of potential improvers for a fence. It was more like the here and now horse, whereas two runs over fences, second behind Lorena, and on Song Lorena, who probably hasn't shown her best since, unless she bled badly at Leopardstown and then disappointed at Sandown. I'm not sure Melinda is just good enough to beat these other fences. Beat Captain CJ last time. Is that good enough to win an RSA? I'm not sure. Not for me, I'd have Champ a clear favourite anyway.
That's why I'd have Champ as favourite. Just on what they've achieved over fences. Simple. Melinda could win the race and no one would be surprised at all. And he'd be a deserving winner, but yeah, based on what they've done on the fence, I'd have Champ as a favourite, and Kasim Ikea would be quite keen on backing that as well.
Yeah, okay, right, let's move on. I know you're both quite keen on the cross country, so take it away.
I think we're the only two people in town for me, quite big fans of the cross country race.
It's a novelty race, but I love it, I've always liked it. You know, grew up watching the days of JT McNamara ride, Spot the Difference, and go around these fences, and it's just something different, you know, if they're going to make it a 5-day festival, which hopefully they don't. It's obviously here to stay. I think it's here to stay anyway.
I think it should stay. It's a nice break where it falls on the card as well. It's sort of something different, especially with the star names you've had for the last few years. And what have we got in it this year? Obviously Tiger Roll comes back. And Tiger Roll speaks for itself. We don't need to sit here and list these achievements. But we've also got Mike Bite in there.
Yeah, and a Gold Cup runner-up in Mike Bite, an ex-champion hurdle favourite in Yanworth.
Real
few French raiders, you know, Easy's Land, he was really impressive when he won here last time.
Yeah.
And then just to touch on Urgent Tigre again, he might be worth a place bet, place only, because he does travel through these races like the best horse. He just finds absolutely nothing for pressure.
He always runs his race at Chandler's, I think he's disappointed at Pau in France the last sort of under what he's usually achieved over there, but he absolutely can't knock what he's achieved at Chandler.
Yeah, if he's about 12-1, if you want to back him each way, I couldn't put you off it, but just a place bet only is probably your best bet.
I think,
but I won't be surprised if Easy's Land beat Tiger Roll. I think he's a really nice horse for these conditions.
Just want to see Tiger Roll come back safe and sound and go to
the
national, really, don't we?
Yeah, well, that's the thing. Do you think they'll have him fully tuned up? Yeah, I think they will because it's Cheltenham. But
I don't think they'll necessarily need it to be fully tuned up the last couple of years as well. So
that's
it'd be interesting
if
he is, because obviously he is going to have a stern test with Easy Land. Obviously, look at the price point. Is he a Shades of Odds on now, Tiger Roll?
Five to six, four to five.
As he has been last year, at least. So
interesting race. Okay, we need to move on. We're gonna.
That's the one on the cross country.
Yeah. Okay, we're gonna talk about jockeys quickly. Kieran, have you found any interesting jockey bookings for today?
Not so much jockey bookings in such. I'll throw out a time form smart start. Nico de Boinville has a 20% strike rate at Cheltenham in general, probably because he's riding the best horses for Nicky Henderson, but he's probably worth following. Maybe he's on Burrow's Edge, I think, in the Coral Cup and a few others, so he's probably one to look out for.
You have touched on the Power in the RSA
as well. That was probably interesting as to why he rides Slate House over Copperhead. Yes, there wasn't so much eye catching jockey bookings that really took my eye as such. But
yeah, okay, fair enough. I know you're having a look at trainers, aren't you?
Well, it's a jockey change, but it's more notable for the trainer change. It's Canardia, who sort of an eye catching. Was it fifth in the Cobb Cup last year?
Yeah, for Dermot.
Yeah, and it's now Willie Mullins, and this will be the first start for Willie Mullins on the back of a break. So that's interesting in itself. Suddenly, is it just £4 higher than it was in it last year? It went on a lot of people's trackers after last year's performance. So if Willie has managed to find £4 of improvement for it, you'd imagine he'll get at least a place.
Yeah, you won't put that past him, will
if
you?
It's not as strong a renewal as it was last year, there's every chance it could win.
Just touching on trainers, got another Time Farm smart stat. William Mullins in races in chases up to 2 mile 3 has a 35% strike rate. So that's over 1 in 3. So that goes well for Chasson Fossoir as well if people are into the stats.
Yeah, good, good.
There's another trainer who didn't catch my eye as such, but just quite a notable one who'd been at Cheltenham race and been sort of quite shy in the bet in his Panic Attack that's actually left.
Yeah, I was looking at that this morning.
And gone to David Pipe.
They're a fair amount as well, I think.
It was a lot, yeah. Is it 400,000 games?
Something like that, yeah.
I know the owners, they've never been shy of buying one for a few quid. Mm-hmm.
I think it's top on the Time Farm.
Yeah.
Just in ratings, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Getting the £13. Whether having only had one run in a life and being a 4-year-old filly, he's sort of going to have enough wherewithal to win that race. Mm. It's a different matter, but I mean, if she were to improve on that first run and handle the occasion, then she should be beating
them. Yeah,
I think
she's the chance, yeah, definitely. Okay, do you have any opinion on race tactics today?
Just touching on the champion chase, pace-wise, who do you think's going to make it? I wouldn't be surprised if Paul Townend went forward on Chasson Fossoir. Bundoran's led in the past, it just depends if he can lead a championship pace.
Mm.
I wouldn't be surprised if Dynamite Dollars maybe went handy as well, but it wouldn't surprise me in the slightest if Townend tries to make all, really.
Do you think Alto would have gone forward, gone straight to the front with a lack of pace in that?
No, I don't think he would have done. I think he'd probably tried to take a lead.
Possibly gone if nothing else was keen to.
Potentially, although I know it was the other way around, but when he's led in the past, I don't know if he's. I think he needs something to run at, really.
Can you imagine somebody's going to have an idea of sort of the supporting cast as I labelled them earlier, play log? Dynamite Dollars, one door. Imagine so one of them's going to think best chance of winning is to try and nick this from the front.
Yeah.
I think Sorrel's probably going to be done if there's no pace, because that's a horse that just needs smuggling into the race at a decent pace and just produce it right on the line, isn't it? So you can't imagine the race going to be run to suit that.
Just to touch on the Coral Cup as well, the start of the Coral Cup, I watched the course walk with Lydia and Ruby on Racing UK, if anyone's there. Not seeing that, it's definitely well worth
watching. Yeah, he's good actually, yeah.
He was just saying about the start of the Coral Cup, it's very tight from when they have to walk sort of from the chase course to the hurdles course, and he said always every year you get more whizzing around the outside trying to be in the first six, it can get very rough. So it'd be interesting, especially if there is a standing start as well, like there were three standing starts yesterday.
When you look at a lot of handicaps tend to be one for problem runners, so there will be a lot keen. Yeah, right up there as well, aren't they?
I think the nature of the course as well, we're going to the new course tomorrow and Friday, the old course this week, the first 2 days, it's just quite sharp in nature. You come out the back, jump the one at the top of the hill on both courses, and you turn in again quickly. I just think it favours prominent racers. We saw, like, so put the kettle on Nefert on yesterday, the conditional racing prominently. And I just think that's really going to suit prominent racers. You know, even in a fast run handicap, it can be hard to make up ground coming down the hill when ones in front are potentially, you know, 5-6 lengths in front of you. So tactically wise, that would probably be one for me. Look out for prominent races.
There's nothing else could really focus to now in terms of that.
Yeah, okay, fair enough. I think that's about everything from us. Yeah.
Yep.
If you have any questions for tomorrow's panel, then get in touch on Facebook or Twitter and we'll try and get through as many as possible. But